Hello, everybody. This is Lorri Anderson, contributor for freedomoutpost.com and co-host for Resurrect the Republic Dirty Uncle Sam Radio on RBN Network. I wanted to address a couple of things and then about the Clinton cash situation. I had an individual, and I'm not going to name names because obviously this individual didn't understand what was going on, so I want to make this clear. A lot of individuals have asked me or accused me of copyright violation, if you will, and me making money off of AdSense. So before I go into the greater situation, let me explain something. Breitbart has made Clinton cash free to everyone. I make no money whatsoever off of ads. I do not do AdSense, and I'm getting ready to show you this. The situation when it comes to copying something for educational purposes, as long as I am not making money off of it, then I am not violating anything when they have made it free to the public. So let me scroll down. I'm going to show you there is absolutely no monetary going on. Now, this is the Clinton Cash official documentary that I copied and I put up. This says includes copyrighted content. Now, let me show you what that means. As you can see, I am not making any money off of this video or actually any of my other many videos that I put out there, because what I put out there for truth. I do not put anything out there in order to make money. So I'm going to click on that. This monetization was monetized by the claimant. There are three copyright claims on the video. If I agree with the conditions, I do not have to do anything. Now let me show you who has the copyright. The copyright is Jagged Edge. These are the people who are doing the music. I had the option of taking the music out right here. See, remove the song. File a dispute. I have no dispute with that. That is their music. They have earned that. Why would I remove the song? And when they have been such a huge part of helping to make this information available to everybody, they have earned their copyright and they should earn money off of their creations in order to help with Clinton cash. But I wanted to make that very clear. I myself am making no money whatsoever off of any kind of AdSense things. And I don't know. However, I would say if you're trying to do this and then trying to put AdSense on your videos to make money off of it, that could possibly turn into a copyright infringement. I am not sure. I am not very well into the copyright laws, but I do know that Breitbart has made it free to the public. This is why I copied it, so that you all had the availability to see Clinton cash and get it out there. I did not do it for any type of monetary gain whatsoever. As you can also see, there are no viewing restrictions. So I've agreed to allow those ads for the people who have the copyright, which is the creators of the music in Clinton Cash. They deserve those funds coming to them. The individuals that worked on Clinton Cash did a phenomenal job, and I really wanted to make that clear. So now I'm going to skip over and show you what you have been responsible for. Yes, you, the people, we the people around the globe, whom have been sharing Clinton cash. We, whom are getting the truth out there, have already started making a difference. The gentleman who was responsible, and all the people who were responsible for making Clinton cash, did a phenomenal job at exposing the corruption. However, CEO in a different country has now stepped down from his position because of the exposure in Clinton Cash, which is phenomenal. And it couldn't have happened without each and every one of you sharing this video, getting this message out worldwide, because this is a worldwide issue. This is not a United States of America issue. This is a global issue. This lady and her husband are destroying people around the globe. And with us speaking out, with us working together, with us pushing out that truth, we can take these criminal, elite, globalist bankers and thieves and murderers out of the equation by simply spreading the truth. It is making a huge difference. As you can see over here on Breitbart, as I stated earlier, right here, watch Clinton Cash for free on Breitbart.com. They have decided that they're going to leave it free because of how huge it has gotten on the internet and the difference that it is making around the globe. And that means that they're in it for the right reason. So the day after Clinton Cash films, Ericsson revelations go worldwide and the CEO steps down. Just one day after the global premiere of Clinton Cash, Hans Westberg, the embattled CEO and president of telecoms company Ericsson, stepped down as the head of the Swedish wireless equipment maker. Though the telecom giant's announcement to remove Westberg is not confirmed as a direct result of the film's online popularity, the company timing is an odd coincidence. Odd coincidence indeed. These corrupt individuals are coming down like dominoes. Whether it be the BRICS exit, people in France are now calling for an exit out of the EU, these globalist elite bankers who have been in control for so long, their power structure, the illusion of them being all powerful, has been broken. And it's because of people like you. The New York Times best-selling book, Clinton Cash, authored by Government Accountability Institute President and Breitbart Senior Editor-at-Large Peter Schweizer, highlighted that Ericsson, on Westberg's watch, had come under heavy fire for selling telecom equipment to countries that were considered state sponsors of terrorism by Hillary's State Department. The company had received a letter in late 2010 from the Securities and Exchange Commission warning about the sales to oppressive governments. U.S. diplomatic cables noted that the State Department officials had regularly and increasingly raised Ericsson's transgressions with the Swedish foreign minister. June 2011, the State Department began drafting a list of specific goods and services that should be covered under expanded sanctions that were to be imposed on Iran and other state sponsors of terrorism. Meanwhile, Ericsson decided to pay Bill Clinton more money than he had ever paid for a single speech, $750,000. In the previous decade, Ericsson had never sponsored a speaking engagement for either Hillary or Bill Clinton. During his November the 12th, 2011 speech at telecom conference in Hong Kong, Bill Clinton spoke in general terms about the positive role telecom plays in our lives. One week later, on November 19th, the State Department unveiled its new sanctions list for Iran. Telecom was not on the list. In an interview last month on Fox Business Newsweek, Schweizer said that indeed, 7 days after Bill Clinton got paid, Hillary Clinton's State Department issued a statement that said, "We're going to ask the company to police themselves." In April 2012, President Obama signed an executive order imposing sanctions on telecom sales to Iran and Syria, but those sanctions did not cover Ericsson's work in Iran. Again, all of this had been laid out in meticulous detail in Clinton Cash. Clinton Cash, the movie, exposes the disturbing pattern, as detailed in Ericsson's case, of record-high speaking fees to Bill Clinton and donations to the Clinton Foundation for foreign contributors, which conspicuously coincided with favors for Clinton cronies while Hillary Clinton was Secretary of State. Ericsson Chairman Leif Jonasson listed increased competition as the reason for Westberg's departure and said the board had decided to find a new leader, quote, to drive the next phase in Ericsson's development, unquote. However, with so many of the companies who were financially supportive of the Clinton Foundation, Ericsson paid Bill Clinton a massive amount of cash, only to find U.S. government actions being made in its favor. I will include all links in the description box below. I want to thank you very much for staying in tune. Thank you very much for sharing and helping to get this information out and helping to get these criminals out of situations that will harm the people. I want to say thank you. God bless you. Semper Fidelis. And of all things, watch your back and check your facts. Thank you. God bless you and good night.